We're nearly entering phase 2 of summer, but still have a few more servants left to cover. Hello everyone, Soberoni of G&A Reviews here, with a brand new servant spotlight. This time we'll be taking a look at Caldia's hottest mama, Ryko Lancer. We'll be examining her stats and skills, as well as going over pointers on how to utilize her effectively, and an overall grade comparing her to how she stacks up to the other 4-star servants. Now, onto Ryko's stats. Ryko has a max HP of 12,112 and a max attack of 9,168, which becomes 9,626 when accounting for her class damage modifier. Compared to the other Lancers in her rarity, her HP is average while her attack is very good. But strangely, she has very high HP and average attack when compared to all other 4-stars in general. Overall, her stat spread is balanced, and she isn't lacking much in either HP or attack. Taking a look at her skills, her first skill is Public Morals Chairwoman of the Shadows, rank A. It increases her crit star gather rate for one turn between 500 and 1000%, and it also increases her crit strength for one turn between 30 and 50%, both depending on level. Her second skill is Wheelbarrow of Tempered Steel, rank C. It increases the Buster Card effectiveness of an ally for 3 turns, between 20 and 40% depending on level, and it also removes all debuffs. And finally, her last skill is Summer Catastrophe, rank EX. It increases the attack of all allies for 3 turns, between 10 and 20%, and it also increases their critical star drop rate for 3 turns, between 20 and 30%, both depending on level. As for her passives, she has Magic Resistance rank C, which increases her debuff resist by 15%, Riding rank A+, which increases her quick card effectiveness by 11%, Madness Enhancement rank C, which increases her Buster Card effectiveness by 6%, and Divinity rank C, which applies damage plus 150 to all her attacks. Taking a look at her deck and Noble Phantasm, Lancer Ryko has a quick Buster deck with quick Arts Buster Buster and a Buster Noble Phantasm. Her Noble Phantasm, Shaku Daikon in Kongosha, deals significant damage to a single enemy with between a 600% and 1000% damage modifier, depending on level, that ignores defense. And it also grants her between 20 and 40 crit stars, depending on overcharge. Taking a closer look at her cards, we see that her quick card hits 3 times, her arts hits 4 times, her buster hits once, and her extra attack hits 5 times. She has an NP gain rate of 0.75% and a star rate of 11.8%. This translates into very good NP gain due to the very high NP gain rate and 4-hit arts. And she also has some good star generating because of the double quick cards, high hits on her extra card, and her riding passive. Ryko Lancer, as you may have guessed from her skills, is an offensive juggernaut. Stat-wise, she packs both good HP and attack, and she has some strong star gen and excellent NP gain. But where Ryko really shines is her kit, which is packed to the gills with insane buffs and steroids. Her first skill, Public Morals Chairwoman, grants her a huge star absorb buff and crit damage buff. This skill makes it easy to maximize Ryko's burst damage in a single turn, enabling her to crit for heavy damage with her buster cards whenever she needs to. Her third skill, Summer Catastrophe, fuels her crit-based damage by giving all your allies not only a good attack buff, but a strong star gen buff as well. The low cooldown on the skill allows it to be active for most of the battle, which significantly empowers your entire team's star generating. And finally, Ryko has her signature skill, Wheelbarrow of Tempered Steel. This is a targetable buster buff that is like Mana Burst Light. Instead of a 50% buster buff for a single turn, it's a 40% buster buff. However, in exchange, it lasts for 3 turns, and it also removes all debuffs, making it a lot more versatile and quite honestly a lot better, as 40% is still a significant damage buff. Ryko can choose to target herself with the skill to do even more burst damage, or play a semi-support role and target another ally. Skill leveling for Ryko should be Wheelbarrow of Steel first, since it is your best damage buff, followed by Summer Catastrophe for the higher uptime on your charisma and star generating, and then Public Morals last because it has the lowest uptime. Ryko's Noble Phantasm is a single target buster attack that deals huge amounts of damage and also pierces defense. It also generates a lot of stars, very similar to her Berserker version. Ryko is not lacking in firepower. Thanks to all of her buffs, she can put out a lot more damage with her Noble Phantasm than most 4-stars. In addition to that, she can also be an excellent crit lancer. She has good star generating, which is only strengthened by her third skill and the Star Bomb effect on her Noble Phantasm. so she's quite self-sufficient, and she has no problem producing enough crit stars for herself. Being able to crit between Noble Phantasms also means her damage doesn't fall off when her NP is down. She will hit hard constantly because of her self-sustaining crit engine and high uptime damage buffs. Not that it matters much, as her NP gain is very strong and she can easily Noble Phantasm multiple times in a battle, provided that you land crits on her arts card. As amazing a solo damage dealer as she is though, much like Maid Alter, Ryko Lancer has a unique niche as an offensive support. She's able to provide the entire party with a high uptime charisma buff and a good star gen buff. The star generating buff shouldn't be underestimated because it enables a lot of buster crit teams without having to depend on a sole star generator. For example, even when paired up with heavy offensive servants like Tamamo Lancer or Brynhilda, Ryko's buff makes star generating consistent enough to not need some kind of assassin feeding your team stars. But of course, her best support skill is Wheelbarrow of Tempered Steel. When not using it on herself, she can cast this on any ally to dramatically increase their damage output for 3 turns, or even to remove debuffs like self-inflicted stuns. Of course, debuff removal gives this skill a good challenge quest application as well, especially with the rather short cooldown given what this skill offers. But being able to give any ally a super steroid is a powerful tool that enables Ryko to fit into nearly any buster team and make it better and more consistent. Unfortunately, strong offense is just about all Ryko Lancer has. She does lack any form of defense, making her extremely fragile, so she does need to depend on a good support to keep her alive. And while she is self-sustaining, she is heavily crit dependent. Her damage and NP gain will drop like a brick if you're not able to crit often, which has a domino-like effect of making it harder to NP and thus generate stars to feed yourself. In other words, Ryko is prone to snowballing, but at the same time, if another servant is taking her stars and she isn't constantly fed, she can just as easily fall off the wagon. For team comp, there's only one place Ryko belongs, and that's in a buster team. She's as buster servants get. You'll want to stack her with a support who can keep her alive given her lack of defense, so servants like Nightingale, Mosh, and Nero Bride are excellent choices, because all three of them have double buster decks, so they won't skew your deck with arts cards. Mosh also provides great hard defense, while Nero and Nightingale have strong heals and can bolster your damage even further. Also, while I make it a policy to never mention Merlin in my spotlights, I'd be crucified if I didn't say that he works perfectly with Ryko in nearly every way, probably more so than any other buster servant in the game. Once you have someone in place to keep Ryko alive, you should also pair her with offensive buster servants who can benefit from crits. Servants like Brynhilda, Rama, and John Alter. Brynhilda has unmatched synergy with Ryko, as she can provide her with a heal, as well as even more star generating, crit strength, and star absorb. And Rama and Jolter are two of the strongest buster crit servants in the game with heavy single turn burst, but they do lack star generating, which Ryko is more than capable of providing thanks to her summer catastrophe. Ryko's Bondcraft Essence is Kyogoku. It improves party buster and quick card effectiveness by 10%. Not bad, but you're better off running CEs that provide a bigger buster buff. You can build Ryko in one of two ways, as an offensive support or as a buster crit monster. If you have her playing offensive support alongside someone like Rama or Gil, then focus on more star generating CEs like 2030, Maiden Leading Caldia, or Hot Spring of the Moon. Otherwise, if you want to maximize Ryko's damage itself, then crit buffing CEs are best. CEs like Talk of the Hot Sands, Joint Recital, Victor of the Moon, or Holy Night Supper. Basically anything that focuses on improving your crit damage, your buster damage, or both. For future proofing, Ryko has many options, but I suggest looking out for Hero on the Beach, which is excellent for snowballing as it provides stars and crit and buster damage, or you can go with Dress for Demons to improve your star generating. Overall, Ryko Lancer deserves her reputation as one of the elite Lancers and 4-star servants. She can consistently deal very high damage thanks to her crits and low cooldown buffs. She is very self-sufficient, being more than capable of providing her own buffs and crit stars. She has unmatched utility for an offensive support, since she can significantly boost the star generating and overall damage of any buster team. and her solid NP gain lets her Noble Phantasm multiple times in most battles, something that many Lancers struggle with. She does still have an Achilles heel in her utter lack of defense and her over-dependence on crit stars, but these are things that are very easily compensated for with nearly any support servant. So she gets an A from me. Simply put, Lancer Ryko puts most Lancers to shame, and she doesn't even need any complicated team to get herself going. She can squeeze into just about any party of Buster Servants and make a huge impact and be monstrous all on her own. And those are my thoughts on Ryko Lancer, without a doubt the best 4-star of the summer. But let me know what you think in the comments below, and if you plan on rolling for her. Also, if you haven't seen them already, be sure to check out my other servant spotlights for the summer servants up on screen right now and in the description. And don't forget to leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and consider subscribing if you really enjoyed the video. Join the party over to Discord, chill with us on Twitch, and follow us on Twitter. And I'll see you all in the next servant spotlight. Soberoni out. Later.